be with you. Today we come together in this now rededicated and reconsecrated Cathedral Basilica of St. Michael to give thanks to God for his blessings in our lives, and in a very particular way to give thanks to the Lord and ask his blessings upon all who have made possible this glorious restoration of the Mother Church of our Archdiocese. In a very particular way, I thank Father Bush for his visionary leadership that led the way for so very many years to make this possible. And for all, especially all of you here present, whose creativity, devotion, sacrifice, and extraordinary work have made this possible, have rebuilt this cathedral. To you, I pray the Lord to bless you, and I thank you on behalf of all of the people of the Archdiocese. I thank all those benefactors who have made possible this restoration. Here we may once more celebrate the sacred mysteries, giving thanks to God and drawing strength in our own lives so that we may move out from this holy place to serve the Lord and to serve those who are most in need. And so as we begin this celebration of thanksgiving, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father who intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you. as we celebrate this Holy Eucharist, we do so on the feast of St. Michael, heavenly patron of this cathedral and of our Archdiocese. And we ask his intercession and that of all the angels and saints and thanksgiving for the tremendous work which has made this cathedral basilica of St. Michael so glorious. And it is a time for us to ask the blessing and to give thanks for all of the heaven, all of the benefactors who have made this possible through their generosity throughout the diocese and beyond. And a special time of thanksgiving for the visionary leadership of Father Bush and the creative, magnificent, wonderful work of all, especially all here present, whose work on the restoration team as members of the team have created, have rebuilt this glorious cathedral basilica. We ask St. Michael's prayers and blessing upon all who have made this possible. O God, who dispose in marvelous order ministries both angelic and human, graciously grant that our life on earth may be defended by those who watch over us as they minister perpetually to you in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As I, Daniel, watched in my vision, thrones were set in place, and an ancient one took his throne. His clothing was white as snow, and the hair of his head like pure wool. His throne was fiery flames, and its wheels were burning fire. A stream of fire issued and flowed out from his presence, and thousands served him, and 10,000 times 10,000 stood attending him. The court sat in judgment, and the books were opened. As I, Daniel, watched visions in the night, I saw one like a human being coming with the clouds of heaven. And he came to the Ancient One and was presented before him. To him was given dominion and glory and kingship, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not pass away, and his kingship is one that shall never be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Before the angels, I sing your praise, O Lord. Before the angels, I sing your praise, O Lord. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the angels, I sing your praise. I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your steadfast love and your faithfulness. Before the angels, I sing your have exalted your name and your word above everything. On the day I called, you answered me. You have increased my strength of soul. Before the angels, I sing your praise, O Lord. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord. How great is the glory of the Lord. Before the angels, I sing your praise, O Lord.
A reading from the book of Revelation. In my vision, war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought back against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent who is called the devil or Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. Then I, John, heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our comrades has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. But they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their death testimony. But they did not cling to life, even in the face of death. Rejoice then, you heavens, and those who dwell in them." The word of the Lord.
Ministers who do his will.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite to whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered him, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." And Jesus answered him, "Do you believe because I told you I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And Jesus said to Nathanael, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
There is a wise saying in the Old Testament that without vision, the people perish. And I think the completion of that is, with vision, the people flourish. We need to have vision. We need to be able to see beyond where we are at this present moment. Because sometimes in our own present life, we can be overwhelmed by the various cares and difficulties which we face. If we have vision to see the purpose of life, to look beyond the immediate moment, then that gives us guidance in what to do next, how to handle each day as it comes. It gives us consolation, because as we struggle with the particular things we face day by day, we are able to recognize there's much more than that. We see the great context of our life, and if we can see that, we can find not only direction, but hope and encouragement to face the troubles of daily life. Without vision, the people perish. With vision, the people flourish. We need vision as well, of course, to look within our own hearts, to see more clearly the ways in which we need to ask God's mercy and forgiveness, the ways in which we need to do better in serving the people around us. We need honest vision of who we are. The ancient Greeks said that. They said, "Know yourself." And so as we need to have the vision of the glory of God in the context of our life, we also need to look deep within our own hearts and see who we are, to see why we are here and what this world is all about. And that's what this cathedral is for. This cathedral is here to help us to see. To see the glory of God as we look at the glory and the beauty of all this art and majesty, the glory of music that fills this place, the beauty of the Lord God and the plan of God. It is here so that we may flourish, not perish, and so that we may have the vision that will guide us through what is often the very foggy and confused struggles of our daily life. We look at the readings today on this feast of St. Michael, our heavenly patron, and they speak to us of that kind of vision. The first reading is from Daniel. And at the time of Daniel, the people were facing all kinds of problems. They were being overcome by foreign invaders. They had many different troubles. But in the book of Daniel, we hear how he says that in the visions of the night, he could see the greater purpose. He could see the hand of God, and that allowed him to face the troubles that were with them day by day. And because he could write this down, he could share it with us. And down in the years yet to come, the visions of the night that Daniel had helped us as well to be able to be confident in the midst of our struggles and to get guidance on how to deal with the troubles that could seem overwhelming when all we see is what's in front of our face. His visions of the night helped him and helped his people and help us. In the second reading today, we see from the book of the Apocalypse, the book of Revelation. Now, I spent 2 years of my life studying the last 16 verses of the Apocalypse. So that might be a lesson to all the students present that I'm a very slow reader. 16 verses in 2 years, oh my. But it's a great book, fiery, alive. And what we see in here is something that we also need to be aware of. And that is that we have our troubles and cares, and Daniel said we need to be able to get beyond them. But there are also forces way beyond ourselves with which we do battle in our life. And we may have confidence because the hand of God is with us and because the angels of the Lord protect us. It's a great battle against the dragon. And that's what we see in the book of Revelation, the Apocalypse. This is where we hear of Michael fighting against the dragon that ultimately is Satan, the power of evil and the one who is the great master and father of lies. In the New Testament, we learn the world, the flesh, and the devil. This is where we have our problems, all three. And we need to have the vision of the glory and the protection we receive from St. Michael the Archangel to defend us against these evils in our world. And we can see the dragon, Satan, we can see the dragons that face us, the various ways in which this is present in the world. In all of the evils that afflict us, we see the terrorism, the pure evil that happens around this world, which can cause us discouragement and despair, unless we, like all of those who are persecuted, can see through that, those great evils, the satanic power in this world, to see the glory of God made manifest in the one who is like God, Michael. Mikael is the Hebrew for the one who is like God, our heavenly protector, to defend us in the battles of life. That vision gives us strength. And in the gospel today, we see our Lord speaking of Jacob's ladder, where the bottom part of it from the Old Testament is here in this world, is Jacob had a big fight with his brother. This doesn't happen, of course, these days, but he had a big fight with Esau, his brother, and he was fleeing, and there were all kinds of troubles in the family. And he was very discouraged and worried, and all kinds of problems were happening to the people as well. So he had this vision that God gave him of Jacob's ladder, the angels of God ascending and descending. And the bottom part of the ladder is stuck where we live and all the problems we face. And the top of the ladder goes all the way to heaven, to the glory of God. And there's a connection there. We're not alone at the bottom of the ladder, although if we can't see very far, that's all we see is the bottom of the ladder. We have this great connection to God. And the angels of God guard and protect and glorify that ladder. And this is what Jesus says. Jacob's ladder is really Jesus our Lord himself, is the one who connects us to the heavenly courts and gives us strength and hope and encouragement. If we can only have the vision to see that. And that's what this cathedral is as well. Here is the place, like Daniel, where we come in the midst of our troubles to see the glory of God, to hear the words of life that guide us through our struggles, to receive the Lord himself in Holy Communion and the Holy Eucharist, or to spend time in adoration here before our Lord, so that we may see our own problems in the context of God's mercy. Here is the place, as is every church, where we ask for the protection of God, and we ask the intercession of our patron, St. Michael, to defend us in the battles of life, to realize we're not alone. God is with us, and who is like God? God is with us in our struggles, And a lot of life is a struggle. And here we come to this cathedral, this magnificent cathedral. And it touches down here, right on Bond Street, right in the center of Toronto. And it touches down into our world, which is often a world of burden, care, suffering. But people come here, everyone, we all come here, to bring our cares before the Lord. The things, the troubles that swirl around the bottom of Jacob's ladder. And then look up at the glory of God and find hope in that. Find strength, especially in the Word of God, which is proclaimed here. It rings out like a bell, like our basilica bell right beside it, to give us hope in this world. And above all, in the Holy Eucharist, as we come here to ask the Lord to bring his power and strength from on high down to the bottom of the ladder here in our daily lives so that we may have hope and joy and may be strengthened to move out there and bring his light and life into this world. And that is why it is so important that this cathedral shine as a beacon of hope, to give vision, clarity, encouragement to all who struggle in this valley of tears, that by the intercession of St. Michael, we may find our way home after the struggles of our life. And in the length of that journey, we may always be upheld, encouraged, and strengthened by the vision of the Lord God. That is what this cathedral is. And that is why we all give thanks to the Lord for making this possible, and why all of you here present, especially who have rebuilt this cathedral, have offered worship to God in the work you have done, and you have offered a vision to help all who in the centuries that lie before us come here out of the struggles of their life at the bottom of Jacob's ladder to see the glory of God, which draws them up and helps them to flourish. Without vision, the people perish. With vision, the people flourish. And we give thanks to the Lord that this restored cathedral makes it possible for all God's people to flourish in the glory of God and in the service of those who are most in need. Let us now join together in our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, then his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us offer our prayers to Almighty God.
For Pope Francis and all bishops, that they may be blessed with strength to lead the Church fearlessly, inspiring their flock to imitate the holiness of the archangels, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, that through the faithful intercession of St. Michael, our patron, we may continue to grow in a spirit of loving concern for the spiritual and temporal welfare of one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, that they, like the angels, may devote themselves to a life of loving service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us gathered around this altar, that St. Michael may obtain for us the gift of understanding, that during the Holy Mass, we are in the presence of the angels. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the suffering and the sick, that they might find hope in the knowledge of Christ's great love for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful who have died, that they may receive into the company of the angels and archangels in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear these and all of our prayers, which we offer to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. We offer you a sacrifice of praise, O Lord, on this feast of St. Michael, humbly entreating that as these gifts are borne by the ministry of angels into the presence of your majesty, so you may receive them favorably and make them profitable for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise you without end in your archangels and angels. For the honor we pay the angelic creatures in whom you delight redounds to your own surpassing glory. And by their great dignity and splendor, you show how infinitely great you are. To be exalted above all things through Christ our Lord. Through him the multitude of angels extols your majesty, and we are united with them in exultant adoration as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. And with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we breathe this out, we hold it wrong. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At at the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
his name. Let all the earth cry out for the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Let all the earth cry out for the Lord with joy. With gladness give your service to the Lord. Go in before his face with joyful hearts. Let all the earth cry out to the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Know this, the Lord is God. He made us, we belong to him. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Let all the earth cry out to the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Go in before his gates with songs of praise. Enter his courts with hymns. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Let all the earth cry out to the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Indeed, the Lord is good. His mercy everlasting. From age to age endures his faithfulness. Let all the earth cry out to the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Give glory to the Father and the Son. Give glory to the Holy Spirit with them one. As in the beginning, so now and evermore, throughout eternity. Let all the earth cry out to the Lord with joy. Give thanks to him and bless his name.
Let us pray. Having been nourished with heavenly bread, we beseech you humbly, O Lord, the drawing from it new strength under the faithful protection of your angels, we may advance boldly along the way of salvation. Through Christ our Lord. As we come to the end of this celebration of the Eucharist, I would like to have us all join in praying the prayer to St. Michael, which is found in your booklets at the back. This prayer was written by Pope Leo XIII in the 19th century as he looked forward to the troubles that were going to lie ahead, many great disasters and cares. And he composed this prayer, which is based upon the Apocalypse and upon the first letter of St. Peter. And in the years that lie ahead, I think I'm going to be encouraging that everyone to pray this prayer at the end of Mass to ask St. Michael's protection for us in our struggles. So let's join together in the prayer. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Jim Milway. I'm the Chancellor of Temporal Affairs. Some of you will know me as the signature, or you'll know my name, the signature at the lower right-hand corner of all the checks that we've been writing through this process. And I'm just here to thank all of you, all the workers, the trades, who did such a fantastic job with this. You really, really should be proud. You need to be bringing your wives and your husbands and your significant others and your children and your grandchildren here to show them what you took part in and what you created. And so just on behalf of the Chancery, on behalf of the Archdiocese, I just really want to thank you. I've enjoyed working with you. I think I'm going to miss you when you all leave. The biggest part I'm going to miss, I think, is the summer barbecues that we had. That was the best food, the best cooking I've ever had. So again, sincere thank you. Special thank you to the leadership down here at the Cathedral, the three big names, the three firms that led the effort, ButCon with Mark Ferguson, Terry White and Venton Group, and Carol Bragg-Agnolo with Angelus Group, who were here day in and day out working away at this. And it was just a pleasure to work with you. You were great partners, you've done great work, you've done great management, and so thank you, thank you, thank you. In addition to the... I know we had our moments, didn't we, through this process. They say, if you want to go to heaven, you got to die first, and I think we felt many deaths through this process. My favorites were things falling from the roof, the columns being suspect, and us are having to close the cathedral, and the prison-like experience we all felt as we came in when the scaffolding was here. And it was in those moments that you'd ask yourself, how do we get through this? Now, His Eminence is very good at quoting G.K. Chesterton and Cardinal Newman. I refer more to Jake and Elwood from the Blues Brothers. We were all on a mission from God. And so, thank you, thank you. I also want to just draw your attention to some of the statues and the beautiful art you see up here and the donations we received. Our three angels, Michael, Gabriel, and...
Raphael.
I remembered ButCon and the others, so that's okay. The statues were donated by the generosity of ButCon, Venton Group, and Angelus. So thank you very much. Look up, if you can get a chance to look up here, you see the chandelier surrounding the Holy Spirit. That was a gift from the DiCarlo family. And also, special thanks to Demetz Art Studios, who did the sculpture that we see up here, and I think some of the representatives are here today. Also want to get a word in for the Chancery staff, who were working behind the scenes, were working off-site, without whom this couldn't have happened. Particular, you know, David Finnegan and Bill Dunlop, who made sure that we were following the rules, the regulations, making sure we had the permits, making sure we had the money, making sure that all the paperwork was in order, and with John McGraw, my predecessor, I think it was between those three who selected the great people who worked on this. So thanks to them. A special thanks to Arthur Peters, who, through the development office, led the Family of Faith campaign, which raised about $25 million as part of the effort for this. And to Neil McCarthy and the communication staff, who got us through some tough moments, but also through the glorious moments of yesterday, the fantastic media coverage we received. And it was really, really appreciated. You guys did a fantastic job. So I think a special thanks to the Chancery staff, who are supporting the workers through this process. So I know I'm standing between you and those trucks out there, and a particular thank you to ButCon, who's gold sponsor for this afternoon. I think now we will call on the workers, the tradespeople, to come up in two lines through up to the center, and we'll have special medallions for you from His Eminence and Father Michael and me.
May the Lord bless these medallions of the Cathedral Basilica of St. Michael. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May these medallions be always a sign of our deep, deep appreciation for what you have done. It is magnificent. Thank you.
Before we depart, I want to add my own word of thanks to these men and women who have worked on this project. This is a very emotional day for me because this is a great milestone in the life of our community. I've been constantly awed and amazed by the quality of your craftsmanship. Now, people have been asking me over the last couple of days how I managed to do all this by myself. As you, Jim, had pointed out, and the Cardinal, and all these people here, especially my cathedral staff, and the community of St. Michael's, who have been a strong support of this project right from the beginning. And it shows you that what the power of a community of engaged, committed people can achieve. In gratitude, we are offering a free lunch for everybody here today, just as Bishop Power did for the workers who dug out the original foundations of this cathedral. Hopefully you have received your meal ticket when you came in. It's good for all of the food trucks outside. If you haven't, see one of the ushers at the back. And as you are leaving, we are also passing out to everyone here a prayer card with the prayer of St. Michael as a commemoration of today's event. Thank you all.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and remain with you always, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.